In this video, we're going to look at molecular geometry. We're going to use VSEPR model to predict molecular geometry. VSEPR model is valence shell electron pair repulsion model. VSEPR is based on the premise that the regions of negative charge around an electron adopt positions that minimize the repulsion between them. It's important to realize that VSEPR is a model and not a theory. There's a couple of easy ways to think about this. If we think about a rope that is tied to a circle and try to take the ends of the rope as far away from each other, you can quickly see that if we just have two ropes tied to that ring, that we're just going to have 180 degrees. The same thing is occurring if we look at what's happening with electrons. If we had a central atom with two electron groups, an electron group can be a single bond, multiple bonds, or lone pairs. It's just electrons in space right now. If we think what's going to happen is if the central atom has two electron groups around it, they're going to move so that they can get as far away from each other as possible. The two negative charges will repel each other. That'll end up with the two electron groups as far away from each other as possible, which we know is going to be 180 degrees. Let's think about three ropes tied to a ring. If we think about three ropes tied to a ring, again, if we pull those as far away from each other as possible, we're going to end up with a situation where we have 120 degrees between each of the ends of the ropes. If we look at a central atom with three electron groups around it, the same thing will occur. The electron groups will repulse each other until they got as far away as each other as possible. In the case of a central atom with three electron groups around it, that would be 120 degrees. If we think about four electron groups, we often would start with the central atom and the four electron groups all planar in the same space. But if we think about it, molecular geometries are not 2D, they're 3D. So what would happen is that these electron pairs would repulse each other until it came to the new shape, a tetrahedron. This tetrahedron has a three-dimensional shape, and repulsing as far as they can, they get to 109.5 degrees, assuming that all of our electron groups are identical. This is something we have to actually consider. If all of the electron groups are equal, then we will get these angles, 180, 120 degrees, 109.5. Note that not all electron group interactions are equal. If we have a lone pair, that repulsion is going to be greater than a lone pair bonding pair, and that repulsion will be greater than a bond pair bonding pair. We often show this abbreviation as LP to LP interactions, LP-BP interactions, and BP to BP interactions. These are going to modify from the ideal. We can get the ideal by assuming that all of the electron groups are identical, but we need to consider what type of electron groups are there so that we can give deviations from this ideal arrangement. So let's consider the procedure. First, draw the correct Lewis structure of the molecule or polyatomic ion. Second, determine the number of electron groups around the central atom. Third, determine the ideal electron group arrangement around the central atom. Fourth, assign an AXMEN designation. This AXE, as it's often referred to, is a designation to help us classify the molecular geometries. A is the central atom, X is the bonded atoms, M is an integer that gives us the number of bonded atoms, E is the non-bonded valence electron groups, and N is an integer that gives us the number of non-bonded electron groups. We can use this AXE to determine the molecular geometry of our groups. We can use the AXM to determine the molecular geometry group that we'll start with. 5. Use the AXE to predict the deviations from ideal bond angles based on the lone pair interactions, lone pair bonding pair, and bonding pair interactions. And finally, 6, describe the molecular geometry. Let's do an example. Predict the molecular geometry and bond angles in ammonia, NH3. The first thing we want to do is draw the correct Lewis structure. Once we have the correct Lewis structure, now we have to think about how many electron groups are around it. If we look at the number of electron groups, we have 4 electron groups. We have 1 electron group for each hydrogen, bonded pair electron groups, and we have the lone pair, a lone pair electron group. Now we can use this to figure out the ideal arrangement. With 4 electron groups around a central atom, the ideal arrangement would be a tetrahedral-like structure. Notice I'm saying tetrahedral-like because we're going to have to go back and verify. If we look at our AXE model, we notice here that we have the central atom and we have 3 bonded atoms and 1 lone pair. From the AX3E, we'll figure out that the geometry is trigonal pyramidal. This is a subcategory of the ideal tetrahedral, and the normal 109.5 degree that wouldn't be in tetrahedral is going to be decreased between the hydrogens because the lone pair is going to have a higher repulsion, pushing the hydrogens down toward each other, creating a lower bond angle than the ideal. You can use this simple procedure to predict molecular geometries using VSEPR. Practice and become confident.